verse number 11 to 14. Romans 13, the verse 11 to 14. Amen.
Amen.
And read. Romans 13, the verse 11 to 14. And do this, knowing the time, that now it is high time to wake out of sleep. For now our salvation is nearer than when we first believed. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Therefore, let us cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk properly as in the day, not in rivalry and drunkenness, not in lewdness and lust, not in strife and envy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. If that Bible is your Bible and you have a paper Bible, please underline this one. But put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. Yes. Amen. Okay. Let's go to Colossians 3:10. Colossians chapter 3, verse 10. I read. And have put on the new man who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him. Colossians 3:10. And put on the new man who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him. Amen.
Amen.
Today we are going to talk on the topic I've entitled, Put on Christ and Put Off the Devil. Put on Christ and Put Off the Devil. The world is a place where there are so many negative things that is happening. So many negative news that people they want to hear. People they are eager to know what is happening. Not only here, they don't want to know what is happening for the good. The negative things that is distracting them. That is what is happening today. As we as believers, we are not supposed to be in that particular situation. It's supposed not to be our portion or our position for germs or negative things to come into our ears. Because when those things come into our ears, it changes our atmosphere. It changes our physical disposition. It changes our spiritual disposition. We are not supposed to hear those things. Hallelujah. It is God's will for his children, his chosen people, his peculiar people, his royal priesthood, for them to move forward. Hallelujah. That is our position. Hearing negative messages, hearing news, gossips will not take you anywhere.
That's true.
It will make you to retrograde. It will make you to stand still. It will cause you to miss the promises of God upon your life. It will cause you to miss the blessings of God upon your life. There's a particular season that God has caused you to prosper, to go forward, to move ahead. But because you continue to hear negative things, it causes you to stand still. You cannot go. The thing is like, what is happening? As you continue to hear that negative message, we are all human beings. As we hear that negative message, we are bound to try to like think something. As you are trying to think something, the enemy is there imposing the things that you're supposed to do, which is not of your own will. We have to be prepared to shut our ears, not to listen to any negative message. Amen.
Yeah.
This thing can cause you to miss the timing of God's promises or blessings upon your life. Paul, in this particular scripture that we are just reading, he is emphasizing a moral standard for believers. For us to be aware, we should notice ourselves, we should be conscious of ourselves, what is happening. The night is far spent. It is a day. When Paul talks about night, it doesn't mean that you are sleeping. It's like the enemy has brought a mood in your life. The enemy has brought a situation in your life where you think that it is still night. Continue to sleep. Continue to do what you're supposed to do in your sins, in your lethargical self, in the spirit that is not moving you forward. Continue to sleep because others are also doing it. It is not true. It's not everybody that is doing what the enemy is telling us to do. Those people that you think that they are doing the thing that you think that they are doing, like negative things, these are the people that the enemy has blinded their eyes. And those people that are surrounding your life, you're also seeing them doing the same thing. So you want to remain in the same place. That is not your portion. Hallelujah. God wants you to move forward. Amen.
Yeah.
Now is the day he says we should wake up from our sleep. Why should you sleep when others are going forward? They are trying to attain something. No matter your situation, don't sleep. There's something they want to do to better off your life. Amen. Don't sleep. People, they are fighting to attain a higher goal spiritually, physically. They want to go forward. Don't sleep. The Bible even said that a little sleep, the poverty will creep in. Amen.
Amen.
There was, I think it was on Thursday, we were discussing something with my senior sister. So she brought up a topic how a little girl went to another boy that was just about her age. I was trying to tell her problem to the boy. And the boy was trying to advise her what to do. And she was trying to look up to that boy. So I told my sister that don't be surprised that this boy has got the information that this boy has received. The boy is working on that information. And that information is building the boy up in that level that this girl has to look onto her. Amen. Any information that you receive, it will either make you to move forward or it will make you to calm down. Amen. The thing that we are, now that we are sitting and listening to this message, whatever this message will bring to you, it will all depend on you, what you want to do with that message. There are people that will take the message, as Pastor said, they will leave it, they'll reject it, they'll even keep it under the floor. They will not do anything with it. But there are people that are going to take this message, they'll work on it, and see their life move forward in every area that they want to do. Amen. Amen. Don't let the enemy fool you. Sleeping here, I say, it's not you lying on your bed. It means that the devil is putting you in a quiet mood for you to think that everything is okay. Taking, make you to know that there is still darkness. But there is light. People, they are going forward. Amen.
Amen.
He tells you that everyone is in the same situation. It is not true. Everyone is not in the same situation. You have to separate yourself out. You have to come out from that particular place that you are. Tell yourself that you are not the same person like them. Because you are a chosen generation.
Amen.
You are a royal priesthood. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
The devil tells you that it is still dark. While others have caught it up and they are making it, they are going ahead of you. The devil makes you to think that there is still too much time for you. Therefore, you should do what you want to do. You should do the works of the flesh. You should satisfy the works of the flesh. The Bible describes it as rivalry, drunkenness, lewdness, lust, and envy. Today, we want to kick that devil out of our lives.
Amen.
With all those thoughts in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are kicking them out of our life when it brings us the negative thoughts in our lives.
Amen.
Rivalry is a situation that is like party, not loud noise, loud music, but the people, they are dancing. They are doing type of things. And in that particular situation, every Saturday you are there, every day you are doing that type of thing, how can you move forward? You are sleeping. You are sleeping your destiny. You are sleeping your progress. You are sleeping your breakthrough. The devil causes you to be doing those type of things. Drunkenness. You drunk in your sin. Drunkenness does not only mean alcohol. But you drunk in your sin. You remain where you are. The things that you are doing, you continue to be doing it. And even the little truths that you even know, the devil blind your eyes of those truths. And you continue to be doing those things. Amen. Lewdness is talk about shamelessness. In Africa, we say that when you continue to do certain things and people that are talking about it, you don't want to stop. They say that dog has licked your face. You don't care. That is lewdness. You don't care about it. Lust and envy comes as a result. You have given yourself to the enemy. The enemy is tossing you. Everything comes, you take. And at the end of the day, like what my pastor said, those that have already gone ahead, they have sold, they have invested their life, they are being blessed. You start to be envying them, but you don't know the investment that they made. Amen.
Amen.
The devil will bring all these things to you, and he will engage you in those type of things. When he has cast you in his trap, he gives you what you are trying to get through him. At the end of the day, that same devil will expose you. That same devil will minimize you. That same devil will mock you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But it's not our portion, because we that we are sitting right here, we have caught in the light. We have gotten out of darkness. We are right now in the light, trying to do what God wants us to do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says that while the day is still at hand, meaning that when you are aware of the tricks of the enemy, we have to watch. Your day is at hand because you are here. Your day is at hand because you know that the Lord is with you.
Amen.
Amen. You are not watching by staying angry. You are not watching by just staying like that. You are watching and be prepared. that when the devil comes with his or her trick, you know it already, and you catch him by that trick. Hallelujah. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33 to 34 says, "Do not be deceived. Evil company corrupt good habits. Awake to righteousness and do not sin. For some do not have the knowledge of God. I speak to your shame. Awake to righteousness." That evil communication or evil company corrupt your good habit. There are some people that they have good hearts. They have good habits to walk in the ways of the Lord. They want to separate themselves. But when they mingle themselves with evil company, their habits start to be corrupted. The habits start to be corrupted. Paul is addressing those who are already in Christ. He is talking to we that were already in Christ. That we should be very careful because they are dead waiting for us. They are dead waiting for us. He is advising us that we should be watchful. For that evil company, it will corrupt you. We should be watchful because Christ is coming soon. We should be watchful for us not to fall in the tricks of the enemy. We should be watchful for us not to be like a Jessica. Not to do what we're supposed to do. We should be watchful. Our lives have been influenced by what we see, what we believe, or what we associate with. That's how our life has been influenced. There's a little story that I want to tell you. Not really a story, but an analysis. When I came to Germany, I met some friends. I was going to work one day, one very early in the morning. The bus that I was supposed to take, I met this girl. It's a black girl. Me, in my nature, when I meet any person, as I'm greeting you, in my heart, I want to try to talk about the word of God to you. When I greeted this girl, good morning, we answered, all of us will enter the bus. As we entered the bus, I started asking her, I told her I'm coming from Cameroon. She says, oh, I'm also coming from Cameroon. But I was speaking English. We have our broken English, everybody knows about it. But this girl was trying to influence me to speak Pidgin. I resisted. It came to a point that after we went to work, lo and behold, I met so many of them again, Cameroonians. During the break time, all of us were sitting together. They were like pumping that thing in me. I told a spirit of God told me, I said that, no, don't accept it. They cannot influence me. Me, I have to influence them. What to do? Hallelujah. I resisted. Until they started walking me, they said, where are you coming from? You think that they started telling me things, but I resisted. Evil company will corrupt a good mind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the truth of the matter. If you are really a child of God, born and washed by the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, you don't like to hear anything that defames God. You don't like to hear anything that defames the house of God. You don't like to hear anything that defames your brothers and sisters in the house of God. You don't like to hear anything that distorts the name of your pastor. You don't want to hear it. You want to separate yourself from them. Amen.
Amen.
You don't want to hear it. You don't want to hear anything that will criticize God. You don't want to hear it. The devil knows us very well. He knows us more than we know ourselves. He knows our thoughts. He knows our ways. He knows everything. And what he does, he tries to bring you to a place that when he knows that a little seed of him is found in you, he will drag you to that company that will pollute you. And if you are not strong, there's a saying that if you cannot beat them, you join them. That is what the devil is doing. He knows our thoughts. We are putting on Christ. You need to be righteous. You need to wake up in righteousness by denying any form of evil that the enemy wants to plunge you in and bring you out of Christ. We deny it. The Bible says that we are not perfect, but we are moving towards perfection. Every time that we take a step, every time that we read the word of God, every time that we listen to the message of God, we are trying to be like him. We are trying to walk in that direction. And where we are walking, the day is fast spent. The night is approaching. We should not sleep because the enemy goes like a rolling lion looking for whom it is. But the enemy doesn't sleep. But we believers, we are sleeping. Amen. When God calls you a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praise of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. This means that we are the people that we have decided to put ourselves together to seek the face of God. That is why he has called us like that. A peculiar people are those who have obtained mercy and have become a solution bringer, a solution provider, and a barrier breaker. Amen.
Amen.
We are those people.
Amen.
We are unstoppable.
Amen.
We are undeterred.
Amen.
We are breaking forward.
Amen.
We don't let anything to stop us. Amen. We are moving forward.
Oh, yes.
Joseph was one of those peculiar persons that found himself in a situation. Joseph told himself that I will not compromise my loyalty to God and to man. You check it in Deuteronomy, Genesis chapter 37, 39, verse 7 to 9. He denied to compromise it. He said that I fear God and I fear man. The man that has put me here, God has brought me to this place. And the man that has put me here, I fear God and I fear man. I will not do the thing that you want me to do. Even though he was thrown in the prison, he kept his words. He kept his words. He knew that he was a peculiar person. He was a chosen generation. He had been set to bring provision or provide security or provide solution for a particular people. That is why he kept himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 We should be that generation.
Amen.
That provides solution. That provides break barriers.
Oh,
we should
yes.
be that generation.
Yes.
We should be that generation of Daniel that brought solution to the king. When King Nebuchadnezzar was confused with all the dreams that he had been dreaming, Daniel told himself, bring me to the king, let me give him a solution concerning what he's looking for. Let us be that generation. Those peculiar people, we should not mingle ourselves with them. We should set ourselves apart. We should set ourselves apart. Let us be that generation that provides solution. The Deborah's generation. When Deborah told Barak, go and fight this war because God has given these people into your hands. A man told a woman, I cannot go except you go with me. The mother gathered herself, knew the God that she is serving, and they went and brought the victory. Let us be that solution bringer.
Oh, yes.
Let us provide solution in our generation.
Yes.
God has brought us here, Kaiserslautern, to bring solution.
Amen.
God has brought us here, Kaiserslautern, to break every barrier that stands against the things of God.
Amen.
Let us be that we are going to carry that baton.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is nothing that is going to stop us.
Amen.
There is nothing that is going to hinder us.
Amen.
We are undeterred. We are moving forward.
Amen.
We are going to break those barriers.
Amen.
We are going to bring that solution.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. We are going to separate ourselves.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You come a time that so many that will deny you. So many will walk away from you because you want to keep your righteousness. Because you want to walk in the right way, even your family members. But I know that one man with God is majority.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Don't be worried. One man with God is majority.
Amen.
Today we see people, they treat God's words anyhow. They don't even have faith of anything. Their consciences are dead. They don't care. They see the wrong, they say it is a right. People have been involved in witchcraft. Even the people that are here in Germany, they call their parents back in Africa, tell them to go to juju people. They are there in the church, but they still call their parents to go to juju people. Yes. People are involved in the life of promiscuity. And when they're involved in that life of promiscuity, they call you to come and accept what they are doing. They don't care what is happening. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Idolatry. People have entered, they're worshiping other things. People, they worship their cars. People, they worship their jobs. People, they worship their own selves. They don't find pleasure to come in the presence of God. Let us wake up. The time is so fast spent. Let us wake up. We should put off the devil and put on Christ.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Family, if you belong to this particular generation, a peculiar people, holy nation, called out by God, we should disassociate ourselves from such people. Amen.
Amen.
As I said, you can experience a situation that I experienced it. When I decided to commit my life to God, I lost so many friends. They walked away from me. They walked away from me. I was like, am I doing the right thing? Yes, I was doing the right thing. Because the Bible says that the road that is following to Jesus Christ is so narrow. Not many people, they come to that road. Not many, they come to that road.
That's true.
So I know me with God is majority. I do not care about it.
That's true.
I do not care about it. I want to encourage you to be that peculiar generation.
Amen.
Seeking God's activities.
Amen.
In such a time like this, in such a situation, perverse and crooked generation that we are living in, people that they deny the word of God, they deny the power of God, let us separate ourselves from it.
That's true.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 May God bless you as you keep on holding to the things of God. Keep on pursuing the thing of God. May God bless you and move you forward.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The book of Ephesians chapter 5 says, we awake from our sleep and Christ will give us life. Which means that if you don't awake from your sleep, you are dead. 1 Thessalonians says that, therefore we should not sleep as others do, but instead we should watch and be sober. Watch and be sober because the enemy is looking for you. The enemy is planning to destroy you. The enemy is planning to take you away from the presence of God. The enemy is planning to mix your senses, mix your life. It will not be your portion in Jesus'
name. Amen.
Amen. As being watchful and being sober, so the enemy will not find anything in you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Others have slept and they are still in their sleeping. And they are looking for a way to pull you into that sleep. They are looking for a way to pull you into that sleep. Do you know how they do it?
Can't possible.
Do you know how they do it? They come with their complaints. They will tell you, oh, I cannot go to that church. I've been to that church. I've seen so many things that people they are doing. They complain about the pastor. They complain about the message. They complain about the prayers and worship. They complain about the leadership. They complain about everything. They complain. They complain. They complain about every little thing. They complain. And when they complain to you, you give your ears to them. The enemy is creeping to you inside you small, small. Just as a sudden, you that you were so active, busy, committed, dedicated, you want to see you're also complaining. Stay away from them. Stay away from them. Put on Christ. Put on Christ and cast out the devil.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
They will give excuses to everything. They think that they have faced the experiences that they got in the church, and they faced the disappointment that they had from the pastor, everything. They complain and they give their excuse.
Yeah.
They find fault in everything. They are sleeping and they want to drag you into their company. They will not track you.
Amen.
If they sit and they are judging what is happening in the church, they want to tell Jesus Christ what he's supposed to do. But nobody tells Christ what to do.
No.
Nobody. He knows. The church is not a place of saints. It's a place of sinners. That when we come there, God wash away our sins. We accept him as our personal Lord and Savior. He washed our sins and we are moving from one glory to another. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why he says that when he's washing our sins, that he will come for a spotless church. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
They should not talk us out. God has made provision for everything for us to wake up as he is talking to us right now. Because he's coming back. God is coming back. Jesus Christ is coming back.
Hallelujah.
So we cannot sit back and be pointing fingers for one another what the church is doing. If they are pointing fingers for one another, what about themselves? Have they done the thing that is right? Have they? How can we be spotless? But we have put off the devil and put on Christ.
Amen.
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 It's just funny that you see a believer that has been in the Lord. Then when that believer has been in the Lord for some time, he or she went and missed himself. He or herself in the house of their own believers.
Yes.
I want to see the same thing. They are talking the same language. He or she is talking the same language as the unbeliever is talking. It's funny because you have given yourself to him. The Bible says that we should not make any provision for those things. We should not make provision for the flesh. If you want to make provision for the flesh, it's telling you that provision means that you are planning already to go and sin. There is a foresight. There is a foreplan of it. You are making preparation to go and sin. We should not join a company. If you read the book of Numbers chapter 16, the whole of Numbers chapter 16, God is the book, the Bible is telling us that when God brought his people out from Egypt, there were some companies. The Bible says that the Levites, the people that are supposed to do the things of God. There were some companies, some people in those particular group that stood up, they started talking against Moses and Aaron. They started complaining about Moses and Aaron, telling all things that they are doing. So when Moses and Aaron, they heard that thing, Moses sent for them to call for them because it was not good in the eyes of others. They sent message to Moses and tell him that we are not coming. They said that we are not coming. God was watching everything that they were doing. And when God heard it, God told Moses, I'm going to destroy all this generation. Moses went down on his knees and cried to God. Just because of these people that they are complaining and they are disgracing your work, you want to kill everybody. God told him that, okay, separate them. Separate those people. And if you read from the verse number 32, if I'm not mistaken, to the 33 or 34, the Bible says that God opened the earth. After God and Moses have separated the people, God opened the earth. And the earth swallowed all those that were complaining. So be careful not to join the company of those that are mocking the things of God. Amen.
Amen.
Be careful. Don't allow them to draw you back. Don't allow them to draw you back, family. Don't fall in their trap. Don't fall in their lies. The enemy will give you something in his right hand, but when he is taking it, he will embrace you and expose you. That's what the enemy is going to do. Don't fall in that trap. Amen.
Amen.
The lie of the devil is so cunning. It's so tricky. Don't allow them to come nearer you. Jesus Christ says that, I see them coming, but they don't have anything in me. Mm-hmm. Even if they are coming, they will not find anything in you.
Amen.
They will not find it in you. Except you want to give them that audacity to come in you. But if you stand strong, they will flee.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't give room to the devil. Because if you give it to him, you pay it back in full. You pay it 10 times. Paul is admonishing the believers to plan, not to plan ahead or making preparation to sin or falling prey in the hands of the enemy, in the deceit of the enemy. Paul is telling us that we should not make plans. We should put on Christ. We should shame the enemy. God has not brought you this far for you to turn back. He has not. They for you to move from one glory
to the other,
to another.
Amen.
From one faith to another.
Amen.
Build your spiritual muscles.
Amen.
Build your spiritual muscles.
Amen.
And the enemy will not have anything to put on you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us put righteousness as
oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Because the Bible says in the book of Job, chapter 29, verse 14, that I put on righteousness and it clothed me. Let us put righteousness as a dressing. Because if you put righteousness as a dressing, your light will be radiating. And when the enemy is coming, that light will blind his eyes. That light will darken his eyes. He will even tell himself, I cannot go nearer that light because it is too shining when you put on the cloth of righteousness. Amen.
Amen.
Galatians chapter 3, verse 27 says, that as you were baptized into Christ, put on Christ. It says we should put on a new man which was created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. The new man contrasts the old man. The old man has a spirit of disobedience. The old man has a spirit to fight the word of God. The old man has a spirit to deny the truth of the word of God. The old man walks in drunkenness, walk in rivalry, walk in lust, walk in envy. That is the old man. But if you put on the new man is the opposite of the old man. Walk in obedience to fulfill the righteousness of God in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody put your hands for the Lord Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ. Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
We have to know the image that we are being made of.
Amen.
We are made in the image of God.
Amen.
We are made in the image of God.
Amen.
You know who you are. You have to know your value.
Oh, yes.
People should not tell you who you are, but you tell them who you are.
Amen.
You are a child of God. You are worth. That is why the blood was shed for your sake.
Hallelujah.
You are worth. Amen.
Amen.
Man, what would God want that when I totally gave my life to Christ? It was a little bit darkness. But when I came to hear this type of message that they are preaching, I told myself, no, I cannot. It was like I was like a walking shadow, dying spiritually. When I was walking. But I told myself, but when I heard a message that revolutionized my life, I turned back, I said no. Amen.
Amen.
There's a prominent man of God that touches the world now. This man said that when he gave his life to Christ, as young as he is, one day he slept, in between sleep and wake, he had a vision. And that vision, his name was written in. To hell, your name is written in hell. In that particular vision, he saw his name written that you are wanted in hell. So while he was sleeping, he thought that he was with his own friend that they also gave their life together with Christ. So he called the friend's name. Have you seen my name in that place? So the Spirit of God told him, now stop talking about it, complaining. You have to do something. So in that vision, he revoked it. That I revoked it. My name is written but in heaven. So he got up. When he got up, he was like meditating on that particular vision. The Spirit of God was telling him that you have to double your steps. You have to double your steps. And this man doubled himself instead of knowing that what the plan that God had for him is for him not to do what he is doing, the time that he has given himself to God. But he has to double himself to let all those things that were trying to entangle him to go forward. And if he did not leave that thing, see, so many people would have been dying because of the thing that they would have entangled him. But he let those things. He is not a wonderful man of God, preaching the whole world. Amen.
Amen.
Let us not let the devil take us to hell. Some of us, we are still walking. We are still wearing the clothes of darkness. We are still wearing the clothes of the devil. And wearing the clothes at the same time of the Lord. And you don't even know whether you are wearing the clothes of the Lord or you are wearing the clothes of the devil. Because you justify your own situation where you are. You think that if you go and do it, you come and ask for forgiveness and God will forgive you. That is already foreknowledge. You have planned it. The point is warning us that we should not make plan of you. We should not make provision for those things. Either you are hot or you are cold. The Bible says in the book of Revelation that you should not be in between. Because if not, God is going to spit you out. We should not make provision for those things. We should not justify ourselves. The Bible has warned us. Amen.
Amen.
Can we say that in our life that Jesus Christ is the one that matters?
Yeah.
Can we say if he takes away the Holy Spirit, we don't know where we are going to be, what are we going to become? The Bible says that we believers, we are going to judge angels. Amen. And if we are going to judge angels, we have the power, we have the authority to tell the devil in front of him, no. We have that power. We have the power to tell the friends that they want to relay us into their way. No, we have the powers. We are in this world, but we are not of this world.
Oh, yes.
Even though we are doing businesses with them, we are talking with them, we are working with them, but we are different people altogether. We are different people altogether. God is still leaving us on this earth for us to make them to know that He is that God that came.